Because I felt like I think that would be really good.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're able to do so, please be standing to the right of the bride and party. Marriage is the promise of hope between two people who love each other and wish to share their future together. Today we shall all be witnessing the promises that Fred and Sue are about to make, and I'm sure it means a great deal to them that you've been able to accept their invitation to be present. I'd like to, if I may, introduce the two of us here at the very front. With me is my friend and colleague Joy Henshaw, who is the registrar today with the most important job, as she has the legal responsibility of ensuring the correct details are entered into the marriage register, and she will be preparing and presenting the certificate to our happy couple a little later on. My name is Rachel Creswell. I'm a deputy superintendent registrar for Worcestershire, and that long title simply means it's my pleasure and privilege to be conducting today's marriage ceremony. You all have a very important role to play as guests, as your presence has been specially requested by Fred and Sue to listen to the taking of their vows and to watch as they embark on their new life together as husband and wife. First of all, I have to tell you that this place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriage. One of the historic traditions involved in the wedding ceremony is the giving away of a loved one. Today this act is seen as a symbol of support for her marriage and a promise of continued trust and affection from her family. To you, James, and your mom, to be married to Fred. Lifelong dedication to each other. However, if any person present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, he or she should declare it now. Marriage, according to the law in this country, is the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. I am now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you do not know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. Please answer I am to this question if you feel able to do so. Are you, Frederick Richard Kirkham, free lawfully to marry Susan Marie Barnett?
I am.
Sue.
Ireland.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fred and Sue have declared that they are indeed free to marry each other. So if you're able to do so, please show your support by standing. Fred and Sue, you have gathered about you those whom you love. You invited them here to receive their encouragement and support and to celebrate with you at this special time. I ask you now, in the presence of this company, Fred, do you take Sue to be your wife? Do you promise to comfort her and love her, rejoice with her through good times, respect and cherish her, and do you promise to remain true to her for the rest of your lives together?
I
do. Sue, do you take Fred to be your husband? Do you promise to comfort him and love him, rejoice with him through good times, respect and cherish him, and do you promise to remain true to him for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
The moment has come for Fred and Sue to make their marriage contract with each other, and it is these words that will make them husband and wife. So although you're repeating the words after me, you do need to face each other and you need to speak to each other at this point.
Repeat after me.
I, Frederick Richard Kirkham.
I, Frederick Richard Kirkham.
Take you, Susan Marie Barnett.
Take you, Susan Marie Barnett.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
I, Susan Marie Barnett. Take you, Frederick Richard Kirkham.
Take you, Frederick Richard Kirkham.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
For Fred and Sue, getting married today is a proud confirmation of the love, the respect, and the true friendship they have for each other. Together they'll be stronger to meet whatever life holds for them. Through their vows, they have made a commitment to each other for the rest of their lives. Marriage is not always an easy path. It requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when we are wrong, and most important of all, the strength to put things right. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. We have now come to the exchange of rings, which is the traditional way of sealing the vows you've just made. The wedding ring is the unbroken circle, symbolising unending and everlasting love, and is the outward sign of the lifelong promise you have made to each other. So Tony, step forward please, and if you could offer Fred Susan's ring first, please. And if you hold on to it for me and repeat after me, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
Love and honour you.
Love and honour you.
For as long as I live.
For as long as I live.
Take your time. For as long as I live.
For as long as I live.
And you must obey me.
I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
Love and honour you.
Love and honour you.
For as long as I live.
For as long as I live.
And push the ring and Sue, you have promised you will love and care for each other for the rest of your lives. We hope that the feelings that you have for each other will deepen and grow throughout the years to come. Treasure that love, nurture it and encourage it. May no failure or misfortune ever part you, and may you live full, rich, and most importantly, very happy lives together. You have both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses, your family, and your friends here with you today. You have given each other rings as a further token of your commitment to each other and your future life together. The rings that you have exchanged are a symbol of warmth, love, and understanding. They are a reminder of the promises you have made today. Cherish this special moment. This day will form a milestone in your lives, and you will look back upon it with love and happiness as the start of a new phase of your life together as a married couple. I am therefore delighted to declare that you are now husband and wife. I think you know what I'm saying. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have the signing of the register. Please no photos just at the moment due to personal details in the register. There will be an opportunity for you more shortly. Thank you.
Get some photos with you, Nick.
This little white envelope contains the marriage certificate, and that is traditionally known as the marriage lines, and it's traditionally the property of the bride. Congratulations.
I'll get given it and I'll say, well, pass it on to someone that you love and trust.
It has been a real privilege to be able to conduct your ceremony today, and on behalf of Joy, we really do wish you a lifetime of happiness.
Thank you.
Just before you leave, I'd like to ask you to swap sides, please. And the reason for this is so that now Fred has Sue closest to his heart, where she should remain for the rest of their lives together. Ladies and gentlemen, I know you're going to have a fabulous time celebrating here today at the Old Rose and Crown. Just for the moment, if I could ask you all to please stand. And with a clap and a very loud cheer, please welcome a new Mr. and Mrs.